नमस्ते टू एवरीवन। आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन माय यूट्यूब वीडियो चैनल। टुडे आई विल डिलीवर लेक्चर ऑन फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म, लेक्चर नंबर 8, इन व्हिच आई विल डिस्कस ऑन फाइनाइट फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म। नाउ वी डिफाइन फाइनाइट फूरियर साइन ट्रांसफॉर्म। Let capital Fx, that is function of x, is sectionally continuous over some finite interval, open interval 0 to c. The finite Fourier sine transform of capital Fx on this interval is defined as small fsp equal to integration limit 0 to c capital Fx sin p pi x by c dx, where p is an integer. By proper choice of the origin and the unit of length, if endpoints of the interval be 0 and pi, in place of c we take pi. Finite Fourier sine transform will be equal to integration 0 to pi capital Fx sin px dx. If we put here pi in place of c, here also be pi, and pi pi cancels out, remains sin px. Now we define finite Fourier cosine transform. Let capital Fx is sectionally continuous over the some finite interval 0 to c. The finite Fourier cosine transform of capital Fx on this interval is defined as small fcp equal to integration limit 0 to c capital Fx cos p pi x by c dx, where p is an integer. By proper choice of origin and the unit of length, if the endpoints of the interval be 0 and pi, that is the value of c be pi, then we put here value of c is pi, then pi and pi cancels out, only remains cos px. Here cos px, that is fcp equal to integration 0 to pi capital Fx cos px dx. Now we solve a problem. Problem is find finite sine and cosine transform of capital Fx equal to 1. Now we solve this solution. Let small fsp be the finite Fourier sine transform of capital Fx. Then small fsp, finite Fourier sine transformation of capital Fx equal to integration limit 0 to c capital Fx sin p pi x by c dx. This is number 1. Since value of capital Fx equal to 1, now we put here 1 and then integrating. Integration of sine is cos, and we divide the coefficient p pi by c, limit 0 to c. Now we take minus c by p pi outside, and then put value of c here, then we get P cos P pi C by C minus cos P pi 0 by C. This is cos P pi minus 1 equal to C by P pi 1 minus cos P pi. Value of cos P pi is minus 1 to the power P. This is the required solution for finite Fourier transformation of fx equal to 1. Let small fcp equal to finite Fourier cosine transform of capital Fx. Then small fcp equal to integration 0 to c capital Fx cos p pi x by c dx. This is number 3. Now putting the value of capital Fx equal to 1 and then integrating this sin p pi x by c by p pi by c limit 0 to c. Here we have taken that p not equal to 0. Equal to c by p pi sin p pi c by c minus sin p pi 0 by c. Here we get sin p pi, here sin 0. Since for any integer of the value of p, sin p pi equal to 0, and sin 0 is 0, that is 0. When p equal to 0, then from theory we get capital Fx cos 0 here dx. That is cos 0 means 1 and capital Fx is also 1. So integration of this is x limit 0 to c, that is equal to c minus 0 equal to c. This is the required solution. Now we solve next problem. Find finite Fourier sine and cosine transform of capital Fx equal to x. Now we solve this solution. Let small fsp be the finite Fourier sine transformation of capital Fx. Then small fsp, finite Fourier sine transformation, equal to integration limit 0 to c capital Fx sin p pi x by c dx. Now we put the value of Fx equal to x here, and now we integrate by parts. First function, integration of second, and we divide this coefficient minus integration of differentiation of first, differentiation of x is 1, and integration of sin p pi x by c. Now we take minus c by p pi outside and we write remaining terms and limit 0 to c. Plus minus minus plus, we take c by p pi outside and again we integrate cos p pi x by c, that is sin p pi x by c by p pi by c. Limit 0 to c. Here we put first value of x c here, then we put value of x 0 and we give minus sign here. Here c by p pi and c by p pi, c square by p square pi square. Now we put the value of xc minus we put the value of x 0.
here we get 0 into something 0, here c cos p pi, here c square by p square pi square, here sin p pi equal to 0, and here also sin 0 0, that is equal to c square minus sin by p pi and cos p pi. This part is 0. Equal to minus c square by p pi and cos p pi equal to minus 1 to the power p. Here minus 1 to the power 1 and minus 1 to the power p. That means minus 1 to the power p plus 1 by p pi. Here. This is equation 2. If we put value of c equal to pi, then pi square by pi means pi by p and minus 1 to the power p plus 1.
Again, let fcp equal to finite Fourier cosine transform, then fcp equal to integration limit 0 to c capital Fx cos p pi x by c dx. Now we put the value of Fx equal to x cos p pi x by c dx. We take here p not equal to 0. Now integrating by parts, first function integration of cos p pi x by c is this, minus integration of differentiation of first means differentiation of x and integration of cos p pi x by c.
Now we take here c by p pi outside, x sin p pi x by c limit 0 to c. Here we take minus c by p pi outside and integration of sin p pi x by c is minus cos p pi x by c by p pi by c. Here we get c sin p pi c by c minus 0 sin p pi 0 by c. Here we get minus minus plus c square by p square pi square. Now put the value of x is c cos p pi c by c minus cos p pi 0 by c.
Here we get sin p pi means 0 and 0 into something 0. So first part is 0. Now take second part, c square by p square pi square, here cos p pi cc cancel, minus cos 0, cos 0 means 1, and we get c square by p square pi square, cos p pi means minus 1 to the power p, minus 1. This is number 5. When p equal to 0, then from 4, we get here p equal to 0, that means cos 0. Cos 0 means 1. Only remains x. Only remains x dx. Integration limit 0 to c. That is x square by 2. Limit 0 to c. That is c square by 2. If we put the value of c equal to pi, then we will get pi square by 2. Now we solve the next problem. Next problem is find finite Fourier sine transform of capital Fx equal to 2x. X lies between 0 and 4. Solution. Let small fsp be the finite Fourier transform of capital Fx. Then finite Fourier sine transformation equal to integration 0 to c capital F x sin p pi x by c dx. Putting the value of F x equal to 2x here and putting the value of c equal to 4, 0 to 4, integration limit. And this is number 1. Now, we get integration by parts. First function 2x, integration of second, integration of sin p pi x by 4 is this, minus integration of
differentiation of first, differentiation of 2x is 2, and integration of sin p pi x by 4 is minus cos p pi x by 4 by p pi by 4. Now we take minus 4 by p pi outside, 2x cos p pi x by 4, limit 0 to 4, minus minus plus, here 4 multiply by 2 by p pi, and we integrate again cos p pi x by 4 and we get this result. Now here we put the value of the limit 4 and 0. First, we put the value of x is 4, 2 multiply by 4, cos p pi 4 by 4, minus 2 multiply by 0, cos p pi 0 by 4. Plus, we get here 4, 4, 2. Multiplication means 32 by p square pi square. Here we put first value of x is 4, sin p pi 4 by 4 minus sin p pi 0 by 4, and here we get 8 cos p pi minus 2 multiply by 0 and something equal to 0 plus 32 by p square pi square, here sin p pi equal to 0 and here also sin 0 equal to 0. That remains here minus 4 multiply by 32 by p pi cos p pi. This equal to minus 32 by p pi cos p pi means minus 1 to the power p. Here minus 1 to the power 1 and here minus 1 to the power p. That is minus 1 to the power p plus 1. Here 32 by p pi. This is the required result.
Thanks for watching my video. If you are satisfied with my presentation and contents, then please click on like button and do subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.